every day and giving us services.
Has all the ways gone?
No.
So some of it is still left. So we come down to the urinary system. The waste which the digestive system throws out is all solid waste through the large intestines and the rectum. But when all the nutrition that has been taken by the body and given to the blood, that is the circulatory system which carries all the nutrition, which is again sent to all the organs of the body. So this blood also still has some impurities in the form of acids and, you know, which are in liquid. That aspect of filtering out the liquid waste is the work which the urinary system does. So this is a set of organs which will help in taking off, filtering the liquid waste and then expelling it out of the body through the, you know, the urethra. So the main organs of our urinary system are the kidney, ureter, bladder and urethra. So the kidneys are here, it's a compiled whole of it is showing here in the body. These are the tubes which will carry the waste product which the kidney is filtered, and they will store it in the bladder when it comes out of the urethra. We'll just slowly get into each of these four main organs and understand their functioning and their role in how the body is utilizing. Kidneys, as you know, are bean-shaped twin organs on the left and right side of the body in the posterior wall of the abdomen. Posterior means on the back side. So these, they would touch the muscles of the abdomen at the back. So they're not on the inner. See, our body system is more like a three-dimensional thing. It has got the front, which is so visible. It's got the back, but there is something hollow inside. If you visualize it, there is one slide further down, which will give you this very beautiful picture. If you just concentrate on this, so this is the two kidneys, and here we have got the spine. You've studied the spine yesterday. We've got the spine. And they're almost touching that back. So this picture gives a little three-dimensional effect. Now, since you all have done a lot of correspondence, any idea where could be the kidneys on the hand? All those who know who have done back. It's supposed to be in the abdominal cavity, no? So where are the kidneys? Where is the possibility? Those who are getting treatment are not to respond. They are at the back.
On the back.
So let's get all that. There we are. Right? Along the spinal cord, it is just touching the lumbar area. You studied the different parts of the spine, so this almost is at the lumbar area, the left and the right kidneys. There is another distinction. The left kidney is slightly lower, slightly up than the right kidney. Why the right kidney is slightly below? It's because the liver is there in the right side, and that's the biggest organ in our body. So it takes more space. That's just a minute difference, but it is there. And this will help you when you are identifying kidneys in your hand. You will find so many times that it's not exactly parallel. So everybody is familiar with this kidney. And how do we locate it? You see these two depressions from the fingers, these two central fingers, you join it. And there is a line going like this in this depression. And you will find that suddenly there is a gap. It's almost like a kidney. I'm sure the kidneys have, the Rajma has got the name from the kidney, right? And that's why it's the kidney beans. So this is how we'll put, massage it. First of all, get the feel of the whole as a kidney. And then how do we apply the kidney? Just one side. So this is the germination side. There is this white tip on the kidney. That should be inwards. Just like we have a kidney, little depression like that. Our Rajma is also like that. And that is where it germinates. Wo andar ki taraf karna hai. So that we are exactly in the shape of the kidney, we are able to put it here. Same is the foot correspondence for the kidney. Again, this is the lumbar region. And on the foot also, the distinction between left and right comes out very prominently when you are identifying these kidney points on the foot.
Liver is on the right side.
And this is the biggest organ. Yeah, and that's the biggest organ in our body. And that is why it takes more space. So kidney slightly thoda sa. Slightly, very slightly. And this distinction is not so clear in the hand. It's more so on your foot. So we are okay with this?
Yes.
We come to the next organ. Ureters. Now you know the processing, the filtering, the machine part of our taking out waste, liquid waste is over in the kidneys. Now the plumbing part. Abo waste ko tu chahiye na, we need those pipes to take it. So these are basically the ureters, two, one on the left, another on the right, connected with the kidneys. They will just carry the liquid waste. This is uric acid and various other calciums and ions and all. So this liquid waste is carried by the ureters, which are approximately 10 to 12 inches long. And the process is, there are muscles of these ureters, they will contract and they will expand, and the urine is, the waste in the form of urine is pushed. Every 10 to 15 seconds, a little amount of urine is passed into the bladder through these ureters. And now let's get to the ureters in our hands, through the sujo. So they connect the bladder. We will use it subsequently, because this is where normally you will find the kidney stones getting stuck. So we will subsequently use how to treat those kind of. Right now we are only concentrating on the location in our hands of the ureter. And now we come to the foot. Similarly, this is how it is in the foot. This is simple? Is that okay? I'll proceed. Next is the bladder. Now what does the bladder do? We have used the plumbing, we have done the cleaning, plumbing, and now we want to store it. We can't have a complete leakage out all the time. So we have, the nature has made a storage system, which is in the form of bladder, which is a hollow organ, and it is right at the lower end of the abdomen. And it can store up to two cups of urine, up to 2 to 5 hours. That is in a healthy bladder. The interesting feature about the bladder is that it has a coating. inner lining is so well coated that any bacteria, virus or anything that is there in the urine will not get, will not affect the bladder. Now let's see this bladder. Okay, now the it also has two sphincter muscles. See, if to hold the urine in the bladder, you have to have a very tight band. At the lower end, there is a tight band like this. These are called sphincter muscles. They will not allow any leakage to happen from the bladder. And then another side aspect of this bladder is there are nerves on the bladder. They have a very important role to play. They alert the person, and the bladder is full, the nerves get activated and they tell the brain, okay, it's time to urinate and empty the bladder. Now we come to urethra. This is the tube which passes the urine outside the body. How the process works? The nerves have signaled, the brain tells the bladder muscles to tighten, and which take this urine out. At the same time, the brain will also signal the sphincter muscles to relax so that it comes out. So you see, the whole process has got other aspects also covering in this system, which is the nervous system. It becomes very important. Now let's see the correspondence. We have this bladder here in our hand. This is the area. Between the two legs, simple. Yes. Is that we know, we remember the two legs?
Yes.
Between the two legs, this is the area. And in the foot also. There's some interesting facts about the urine, which I just thought I'll add it for our knowledge. You know how much urine we pass every day? About 1.5 liters. And at night, it almost comes down to half. See how nature has built it up? Otherwise, we wouldn't have a peaceful sleep. So the night time, it is only this much. And another very interesting thing is this urine that we are passing out, it is totally sterile. It has no fungi, no bacteria, no viruses.
Yeah.
No, I am not saying that you follow Morarji Desai and get into that, but it's interesting to know that, you know, let's not have that kind of a feeling towards this excretion that, this must be very bad, harmful. It isn't, it has nothing. Now this urinary system is primarily meant for filtering out liquid waste, but it also has some very, very interesting other functions. And these functions we are not very familiar with. The other important is the balancing of electrolytes. You know the electrolytes? These are the potassium, sodium and calcium. So all the excess and is taken out, but if we have a shortage of it, the kidney would restrict its outflow, and then you will be able to maintain that. So whenever you are feeling weak and there is you are having diarrhea or you are having such problems, we need to cover our kidney points. So it is along with our vomiting, indigestion, all of our stomach points and other points, liver points that we have done in the digestive system, we need to add our kidney points. So another function, major function, is the homeostasis. Homeostasis is what? It is regulating the acid-base combination, the pH value. And we all have acidity problem. And we all have learned how to make the stomach area black and where to put the moon down and where how liver is going to help us to secrete by bile, and there the duodenum will bring the alkaline in our food. All that, but also kidneys, because they are the ones they maintain the acid alkaline ratio. So kidney becomes very important. It's not just taking out urine. It is connected to all the other systems, also the digestive system, in a very big way. And then another function, not only the digestive system, the circulatory system. How?
The blood pressure.
Yes. The blood pressure is actually controlled by kidneys. It may seem that it has got to do with the circulatory system, the heart, but the main function is the kidneys. So a prolonged use illness of blood pressure affects the kidneys. Mm-hmm. You all know that. So how does the kidney do that? They have a capacity to limit the volume of water in the body. Simple, no? Kidney, you can throw out excess water and restrict the flow of water, so on. And we know when the volume of water is changed, you can change the pressure. They have a relationship. So that's precisely what they will do. Whenever you are having low blood pressure, the kidneys will restrict the outflow of water. Your urine will become thick and your pressure, they will try to increase your pressure. Another important aspect if we have observed is when we have acidity, and when it is about to get all right, we tend to pass a lot of urine. Has anybody experienced this?
Yes.
Bar bar we have to go and pass the urine. And one was wondering, ke acidity to pet mein aayi hai, urine kyun bar bar jana pad raha hai? Then that is how the kidney is trying to maintain the balance. So that's where we become to the conclusion that it's important to put kidney points in other system issues also. And what? It also has produces hormones. The kidney, does it produce hormones? It's got nothing to do with endocrine glands. No. There are several important hormones that the kidney has. One of them is calcitrol. This is the active form of vitamin D, which comes from the sun, but is produced in the kidneys. So we all have vitamin D deficiency, no, aajkal? Work on our kidneys. This calcitrol will promote the small intestines to absorb calcium. So, the vitamin D activation needs kidney stimulation. There is another hormone, erythropoietin. This produces red blood cells.
Anemia.
And so many other issues that we have. Of course, whenever you want this, we need to. So remember, kidneys need to be worked at most everything. And all those who come to our clinic are very familiar कि जब देखो किडनी पॉइंट लग जाते हैं whatever your issue, kidney point तो लगेंगे ही लगेंगे. So now you understand the importance that we give to the kidney points. We come to exactly to the diseases of the urinary system. So we are all familiar with UTIs.
Yes.
Fever, itching, passing of urine too many times. So this is the infection, the bacteria, which affects the urinary tract, the urethra, bladder, and if it gets too bad, it goes right up to the kidney. So what is the, when we have severe UTI, where do we get the pain? We get it here. We get it at the flanks and the back. Now you understand why we get it here? Because kidneys in the three dimensions are close to this area. The recurrent UTI problems that we find in the middle age, particularly amongst the women, is where, you know, the lining, the mucosa lining gets little weak. And that is why the infection keeps on setting time and again. Any set of antibiotics, they work only for a limited period. In Sujo, we have an answer to that problem. It is not just one odd time of a UTI. It is when there is a recurrent problem, particularly in women in the middle age. Then Sujo can handle this. We call it that, you know, there is the mucosa lining is not functioning properly. And the, in allopathy, we don't get an answer to this problem. You have to keep on taking different kinds of antibiotics. But Sujo has an answer for it. Then there is this incontinence that we were talking about. This happens in the form of a pelvic prolapse. That means the muscles in the pelvic region are not strong enough. So there is a tendency for a leakage. And then overactive bladder, in which you always have a tendency, the urge to pass the urine. Whereas even when the bladder is not full, now you can understand there is something to do with our nervous nerves on the bladder which are not passing the information correctly. Third condition here is the overflow, where the bladder does not completely empty. These are the very common urinary tract problems. We are going to deal with the Sujo treatment in a short while. The other problems of the urinary system are the painful bladder system. There is a chronic pain, pressure in the lower abdomen area, and these pains and pressure happen due to various reasons. It's not just the infection, the muscles are weak, or there is a nervousness. That's why whenever we are nervous, we tend to go to the toilet time and again, because that link is there. Then of course the prostate gland swelling, that also we can be covered through, it is covered through the reproductive system also, as well as the urinary system. Kidney stone we are all familiar with. They are the calcification of all these wastes and chemicals, they form into a solid mass. So kidney failure, which is also called a renal failure and the chronic kidney disease, because then the kidneys are not able to filter the waste from the blood. So many times diabetes and hypertension also lead to issues with our kidneys and urinary system. So we have the rajma. We have a rajma which does wonders. The natural rajma looks like the kidney. It has a more important function than probably rajma chawal on a Sunday, which we can have it every day on our hand and foot like this. Apply it. So this we have done it once before also.
You can apply
it
to your body also.
No, this is just to tell you. Okay, the joke is correspondence with hand and foot. We don't work on the body. But it is an interesting observation that the kidney in the body as well as the rajma are so similar. That is why you were a little affected. They are so similar. So when we have a pain, renal colic, pain in the kidney area, we can also use moksha along with applying.
This is the moksha.
We are coming to this, how we are going to do moksha in the next session. This is slightly advanced, but then it is interesting that we can straight away take it. In any of the phalange, first phalange here, this point, this also corresponds to the kidneys. And we get some very painful points here. Along with it on the palm or the back of the foot, we can also use it here.
Any of the fingers.
Any of the fingers. Yeah, the smaller one, the smaller rajma. Because this is a very tiny area, but then the points are very specific and very effective.
On any finger?
Yes.
Yeah. Any color also that can be marked?
She said, we put Raj Maya because it's better to do this. We use only red Rajma. We don't use the that other Chitri Rajma, the other color Rajma, because Rajma has a lot of colors and varieties. We use only the red ones.
Even on the wrist or even on the back side?
Yeah. We use only red Rajma. You can also massage it like this. You can pinch it, the kidney points with the thumb and or you massage it with the back of a knuckle. Because it really fits into the depression.
Yeah.
If you try it, it fits in.
It does.
Sometimes when you don't have a Rajma with you, and then in our sujog, whenever there is an, it's one of the important emergency points. Any kind of emergency, in the sense of somebody is having a seizure, somebody is having a stroke, or a heart problem, or some giddiness, any kind of emergency, kidney points are a must. Because it will filter away all the toxins, along with it, the brain point, kidney point, and heart. So these are the three important emergency points, and they are very, very effective.
Kidney, heart, and
brain. So at that time, when we don't have a Rajma, you just need to massage with your thumb, with your knuckle. Just do this. Works. We have had some very good experiences with these emergency points in our clinic. So there is a stone in the ureter. Normally this is what happens. So long as it's in the kidney, it doesn't really trouble you. The moment it comes and gets stuck in the ureter, because it's a thin pipe, there is an obstruction, the free flow of urine doesn't take place, and then the pain sets in. So then what we do is we have a chain of, we can use flax seeds, we can use apple seeds, we have a chain of these applied like this. And we can also use moksha on it. Apply it on both sides. Moksha is the bomb cigar. We'll be just doing it. We'll just do it in the next.
Apple seeds.
Like this. Oh, this is for the stone.
For the
you put on the kidney points and then follow that.
Yes.
On the ureter.
Yes.
This
is not found in India. We have taken this photogram from one of the books.
So what have you used? What seed?
I used flax seed, apple seed. Shamrock is a flower found in this place, Ireland. I tried, I thought I'll be able to get it. I couldn't. it's not found in India. उसके जो बीच के ऐसे गोले बनते हैं ना, they are also very, see they make an energy cycle, circle. तो एक flow है energy का, जिसको हम अपना spiral बोलते हैं, इसे या flow of energy, you might be doing it subsequently. Flow एक energy का है, goes, जैसे हमारे चक्रा system में ऐसे गोल गोल जाता है ना, energy का, और Chinese system में ऐसे सीधा जाता है, तो एक spiral system है. So this is very effective. इसमें ये spiral बन रहा है, तो हम उसको भी लगा सकते हैं।
किसी भी डंडी को
काट। हाँ, काट के ना, you know, वो बाघ काटते हैं तो there are always those गोल गोल चक्कर्स।
So you put that down.
You cut it and you.
And you put it along the.
Yeah, yeah.
The kidney
points. Yeah, you can put it on the kidney points. This is. Closer to the ureter because normally stone यहाँ से यहाँ आएगा ना तो वहाँ पे हमने लगा
कुछ mouth
from the mouth of the kidney अभी there is an acute retention of urine bladder में urine भरा हुआ है लेकिन it's not coming out so then we come to this bladder area हाथ और पैर में massage it outwardly. You want to come out like this?
आउटवर्डली मसाज कर सकते हैं क्योंकि वो रुका हुआ है, तो हम उसमें थोड़ा मोक्षा भी कर सकते हैं लाइक दैट, अच्छे से मसाज करके एंड देन वी कैन अप्लाई.
अगर बाहर कर सकते हैं तो ऊपर को भी कर सकते हैं.
This is the same thing in which we are using in case of relaxation and urine, we are using motion. This is a photo which is like a video. How to use it? How to use the moksha? We are coming to do this. All the urine shows RBCs in it. So this is, that condition is called hematuria. That is the time you never use moksha or you don't heat it. Then we will use moong dal. We will not use kali mirch. This is why it's given in red. This distinction is very important. Every urinary tract infection is not to be treated with moksha and kali mirch. Particularly if there is RBCs in the lung. This is more like a precaution. This is a master point, kidney master point. This comes from the advanced meridian sutura therapies. But this point, we can just pick it up for anything to do with kidney, wherever we want to do it, let us add this. It is in the depression. It's only on the foot, it's not on the hands. This is not the correspondence. So it is, you know, can we make a, do a circular here? This is, in the depression of the two sides, we have these kind of bumps there. It's in the center. These are called kidney endpoints.
So we need to press this point?
Or yeah, we need to massage it circular. This is the motion. It's given.
That black point circular.
Circulate it and then we can put something. We can put matar ka dana, we can put kali mirchi, we can put magnet. Any questions? इसमें कितनी beans नहीं लगाने, ये correspondence नहीं है. इसमें आप लगाओगे मटर का दाना. This is not correspondence, so we don't need to put the shape of the kidney here.
Smile.